we're sitting in my studio and I make music here. I have a lot of meetings here and I also make my light works here. This is where my life is centered, really. What I discovered over the last 20 years or so is something that happens to probably most men as they get older. My voice got lower and lower. That meant not only could I not sing any of my old songs very comfortably, but it also meant that I didn't really feel inclined to deal with those kinds of feelings any longer. So I was making, I guess what I would call ambient music, landscape music, I think of it as. And I started thinking, I wonder what it would sound like if I sang against these. There were birds above. They sang the whole day through. As soon as I started doing that, I thought, this is a new idea to make music which has this kind of landscape feeling, but also has a presence in it. When I'm starting out making a piece of music, I have, I realize quite a few techniques for tricking myself into doing something original. One very good technique, because I use software so much and I'm so interested in software synthesis and software processing, one quite interesting technique is to say, I'm just going to try out this new piece of equipment. Because my feeling very much is that nearly all technologies are invented for historical reasons. They're invented to do a job that already exists, but to do it quicker or cheaper or cleaner or louder or whatever. But nearly all technologies can do something that nobody ever thought of doing before. When I play with something, I want to find out, what can you do now that you could never do before? And very often I think, ooh, that's interesting, that's good. And then it starts to become a piece of music. The way most music is mixed, especially if it's pop music, there are clear focal points, like the vocalist. And then other things go off towards the edges. What has excited me about working with Atmos is this idea of being able to place sound in space, in a proper space. When I started mixing this record for Atmos, I thought, well, I'm not a spectator looking at something in front of me. I'm a visitor in the middle of something. So I thought, I want this music to be all around. With open heart through burning fears. The first thing I did was I put the voice there, where you are, where the listener is, not there. And then I built the whole mix around that. The whole of it, gorgeous flame. Such a jump to move it from there to here. You can't resist it. You'd never want to hear the voice there again. You'd think, that's a bit eccentric. Why stick him on the wall? Sometimes on the album I have very few things going on, but they're in quite different places, and that gives you the sense of a whole ocean of space in between them. I never really had that sense with stereo. In terms of density, this sort of suggests an era of both greater density and less density. It's like the range just changed, you know. They actually have increased the options for minimalism. I make records because I want to change people in some way. I want to give them a set of feelings that they haven't had in those combinations before. then I'm trying to think, why am I moved by this? Why do I want this feeling? Why do I want any feelings? And I become more and more convinced that feelings are actually the beginning of thinking.